Hare Krishna. Thank you for coming today. And do you know what is this? What is it? Crutches. I was in America and the American government told me this is a bomb. Or rather, this contains a bomb. So I'll tell you that story today. Two years ago, when I had gone to America, I entered into America, and you know, at the entrance of any country, you have, or there is, you have to go through security.
Yeah.
So now, because I use these crutches, so I go on a wheelchair. So a person takes me, and then my bag and my crutches, they go through the security machine. So I went through that machine, and suddenly I heard a loud alarm. And before I could understand what's happening, suddenly there are like 5-6 American security people pointing their guns at me. I said, what happened? And one of them picked up the crutch and he came. And he said that, you know, our machine has shared that there is a high explosive inside this. I said, really? He asked me, what is there inside this? I said, there's nothing. It's just my crutches. He said, no. There is some big explosive inside. So he started. He said, we'll have to take you to a private place to screen you. And then he picked up the crutches and he was like looking at it as if it is like a dangerous explosive, you know, holding it from where he put on his gloves and he's holding it. And then he said, we'll have to break these crutches. I said, if you break these crutches, then how will I walk? He says, that's not my problem. And initially I was annoyed because I landed in that city in America, and then from there I had to have another connecting flight to go to a different place. So I had landed in Miami, and from there I had to go to Gainesville. So then what happened? My next flight, I initially thought this is just a delay, and I was annoyed about the delay. But when they said that they want to break the crutches, I started becoming a little alarmed. So now, when this person looking at me seriously and thinking about how to go about breaking this, so I started praying to Krishna. I like to recite the verses of the Bhagavad-Gita. So at that time, somehow I remembered one verse from the Gita, that is 1861, where Krishna says, Ishvara sarva bhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishtati brahmayan sarva bhutani yantra rudhani mahaya. Krishna says that we are all on a machine. This is body like a machine, and we are souls. So we are traveling on this machine, and he is guiding our wanderings. So he's always with us in our hearts. Now when I remember that, I suddenly started thinking that actually I have traveled across many, many countries. I have traveled on maybe 500, 1000 flights I have traveled. So at any place, any time, an accident could have occurred if it had to occur. But through all of that, Krishna has guided me. Krishna has protected me. So Krishna will protect me now also. So as I started thinking like that, my anxiety started going away. I started feeling a little calm. And then I said, Krishna, whatever you want, I surrender to you. And then as soon as I had an attitude of surrender, and suddenly that person, that security person who was there, his boss came over there. And his boss asked him, what is going on over here? So he said, you know, we got a high explosive alert. Okay, he looked at me. He looked at that person. He said, okay, I'll take care of it. I'll handle this. And then he again picked up my crutches. And then he looked at it once again. And he said, can this be opened? And now, I have never opened this, but what is this? If you just move this, you can decrease the size of the crutches. And if you move it fully, you can open it. He said, yes, you can open it. Oh, then we don't need to break it. Let's open it. Then he opened it. That he fully went round and round, he opened it. And then he took the lower part. They passed both the parts of the machine, and he said something was there in the lower part. So the upper part, no sound, lower part, big sound again. Then they started looking inside. And he said, there's something dark inside over there. So then they got some kind of prong and put it inside. They pulled it out. Yes, they pulled out something dark, came out of there. What is this? I said, what does it look like? He said, it looks like dirt. I said, it's dirt. And then he took it out again. And then what is it? He said, it's dirt. So then he took it out once again. He said, dirt. So what? It was always dirt only. So what had happened actually, before coming to, we're going to America, I had gone to Vrindavan. You know where is Vrindavan?
Yes.
Where? Where is it? Okay, what is Vrindavan? What is so special about Vrindavan?
It's in my place.
Yes, that is transcendentally true. Yeah, Vrindavan is Mayapur and Mayapur is Vrindavan. Yes, thank you. Yes. Vrindavan is in India, correct, thank you. What is special about Vrindavan? Yes, it was where Krishna grew up. Wonderful. Thank you. And there is one special river in Vrindavan. You know which is that river? Raise your hand. Let others also give us a chance. Thank you. So, Yamuna. So, I had gone by the banks of the Yamuna and I had taken some sacred water from there. So, now Yamuna, unfortunately, is now very polluted. So, sorry? Yeah, filled with rubbish and from the factories some effluents have come out. So what has happened when the dirt, all that pollutants, when the Yamuna flows, it comes off on the side of the Yamuna. So when we walk on the side, the soil on the side of the Yamuna has very heavy metallic content. And all kinds of metals are there. So when I had gone to Vrindavan, at the bottom of this is called crutch tips. This is made of rubber. And if you use it for a long time, it gets spoiled. So when it gets spoiled, the bottom of the crutches becomes exposed. So when I had gone to Vrindavan, the crutch tips had got spoiled. And so the dirt of Vrindavan had gone inside the crutches. And then I had put a new crutch tip on that. So then what had happened? Some of the dirt had remained inside. And that dirt, because there was a lot of metal in it, the American border police thought that is an explosive. So, it was actually not an explosive, it was simply dirt. But because it was the dirt of Vrindavan, we call it the dust of Vrindavan. So, he took it three times outside, and then he gave the crutches to me. And he said, cleaning your crutches is not my job.
So I said, clean this, I'll clean it, thank you. And then he let me go.
So what happened basically is that at that time when he suddenly pointed those guns to me, I was very alarmed. But fortunately I was able to remember Krishna, I was able to pray to Krishna, and Krishna arranged something by which things got resolved. So for all of us, we also have some time or the other when we feel afraid. Do any of you feel afraid? No?
Wonderful, okay. Yeah, some of us feel afraid.
Are any of you afraid of spiders?
No.
No? Every answer is no.
You're not afraid of spiders? Or afraid?
Afraid.
Little sometimes. Oh, thank you. You know, there's a word for the fear of spiders. There's a phobia for spiders.
So,
what is the word for phobia of spiders, you know?
Arachnophobia. Oh, very good. Thank you.
Arachnophobia. I used to think that those who have arachnophobia, they feel fear when they see a spider. But actually, that's not entirely true. When those who have arachnophobia, they start feeling real fear when they stop seeing the spider. Why? Yeah?
Because they don't know where it is and then they're like it's going to be somewhere around here and it's probably going to jump.
Yeah, as I see the spider, you know, it is there. It disappeared. Hey, it might come on my body somewhere. Thank you. So they feel real fear when you can't see the spider.
So all of us have some or the other fears. And when such fears come, we all have to learn how to best deal with that fear. Once I was at an airport, and there were two kids. One was like a three-year-old boy, and then another was a five-year-old girl. And apparently what had happened was, they were traveling with their dad, and their dad had gone somewhere. So I'll come back in 2 minutes. But then suddenly, one airplane's crowd came over there, and their father was caught on the other side. These two children were there, and suddenly they were all alone on this strange airport without their dad anywhere. And now, strangely enough, as I was observing, that five-year-old girl was, you know, scared. What is going to happen? And the three-year-old boy was not at all afraid. Can you guess why?
Because...
Yeah?
I think he doesn't know what it feels like.
He doesn't know what it is like to be lost, something like that?
Yeah.
Yes, that's one reason. That's another reason. One more, yes?
He might not understand what's happening.
That's true, but... No, there's something more over there. Yeah?
He's happy that his father can't turn him off.
Oh, God. He's happy that his father can't tell him off now. I was talking with one teenage boy, and suddenly his phone came. And he looked at the phone, and he said, "You want to pick up the phone?" He said, No, I'll talk with him later. I look at the phone, and on that phone it was written jail. I said, "What is jail?" He said, "That is my home number." So, sometimes in teenage it can appear as if, you know, our parents are there just to tell us off or to discipline us or to punish us. It's not like that.
There's an American thinker who said that. Mark Twain, he said, when I was 15, my dad was a fool. Now I'm 25, and I'm amazed how much the old guy has learned in the 10 years.
Okay. So what that means is 10 years, the child has matured, so he's thinking now more matured. Anyway, so...
What was I saying? Yeah, that's it. Thank you. So now what happened is, now for that three-year-old boy, his five-year-old sister was like an adult. You know, when you're three, five is much, much older. And because he felt my sister's with me, everything is all right. Because she's an adult. She's older than me, she'll take care of me. But with that five-year-old girl, there was no adult over there. There's no one who will take care of us. So what happens whenever we are in trouble, if there is someone bigger than us, we feel safe. And if there's no one bigger than us, and we feel there's a problem which is much bigger than us, I'm all alone over there, then we start feeling fear. So for all of us, we'll all face some kind of fear. Sometimes in our school there might be some bullies. Sometimes we all may have some difficult problems. So Krishna is always there with us in our heart. And to the extent, we can start feeling his presence slowly if we hear about him, if we speak about him, if we remember him. Now, we may not be able to see Krishna, but that doesn't mean that we can't feel his presence. Just like, are there all these great, all these popular star, like he was mentioning Spider-Man, Batman, Wonder Woman, all these. Now, nobody's actually seen them. But we've watched their movies. Maybe we read them, read some comics about them. Then if you have friends, we talk about them with them. And then, after we talk about them, then we remember them. So when we do three activities, hearing or watching, then speaking and remembering. Then by that, we start connecting. So there are people who are like big, big fans of these characters. So similarly, now when we hear about Krishna, and we speak about Krishna, we talk about Krishna. Have any of you seen this little Krishna? Yes. Oh. It's not a little number. All of you have seen. Wonderful. You like it?
Yes.
Yeah, wonderful. Thank you.
I have seen lots of pictures of Krishna.
Oh, wonderful. I had not seen so many at your age. So you are fortunate.
Thank you.
So when we see, when we see Krishna, when we see Krishna's pictures, we see Krishna movies, when we talk about Krishna, then gradually what happens? We start connecting with Krishna. And whenever we feel fear, whenever we feel that we are alone, we are in danger, if we chant the names of Krishna, then Krishna is the ultimate Superman. Krishna is present in our heart. He doesn't have to come from anywhere else. He's there with us always. And Krishna helps us in many, many mysterious ways. Sometimes he may help us directly by coming, by personally coming. That's what he does with his great devotees. But sometimes he might just come and help through various situations. But the principle is that God helps those. Does anyone know?
No.
God helps those who help themselves. Yes, thank you. So I'll conclude with a small story about that, and then if you have any questions, we can talk. Does any of you know the Mahabharata?
Yes.
Oh, wonderful. Who is the hero of the Mahabharata?
Krishna.
Krishna, okay. Krishna is actually, yes, he's the ultimate hero. But who are the, there are five main heroes. Who has not answered till now?
Pandava.
Oh, wonderful. Thank you. So who are the five Pandavas? Okay, one. Yes? Anyone? Sorry?
Nothing.
Okay. Yeah?
Arjun,
okay. He is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What number?
5.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, it's 3. Who is?
Nakul.
Nakul, yes. He is?
4.
4. Wonderful. Yes?
Saidev.
Excellent. He is?
5.
Oh, good. And 2 are remaining. Yes?
Bhima.
Bhima. He is?
2.
2, yes. Now, who is remaining? Yeah?
Yudhishthira is 1.
Yes, he's 1. Thank you. So that these 5 Pandavas, they are like the 5 fingers. Why like 5 fingers? All of them are very different. You know, Bhima is not only strong, and he loves to fight. And eat, okay, yes. Yes, he loves to eat. Now when the Pandavas would be in the jungle, at that time, they, whatever food they would get, they would get the food, they would divide it into 2 parts. One part entirely would go to Bhima. And the remaining part, they would divide into 5 parts. So the remaining 4 parts would go to the 4 Pandavas, and one part would go either to their mother Kunti with them or their wife Draupadi with them. So Bhima would take big amount of work. And of course he would do big amount of work also. When the other Pandavas got tired, Bhima was so strong that he carried all the 4 Pandavas and their mother on his shoulders. You sit, rest, and I will carry over. See, he would not just eat and sleep. Eat and had a lot of energy. So, now these 5 Pandavas, they were all like 5 fingers. Each finger, if you see, one is longer, one is shorter, and each finger can do its own work. But all the fingers are united by what? The palm. So Krishna was like the palm. So Krishna united all the Pandavas. All the Pandavas were all together for serving Krishna. Now who is the main villain in, who has not answered till now? Anyone? Yes? Duryodhan, yes. And he had how many brothers? Yes? Duryodhan had how many brothers? Any idea? Yeah? 100?
99.
Yes. including Duryodhan?
Oh no, 98, because he had one sister, right?
Oh, that is 101.
Oh yeah. Yeah. 98.
So, 99 brothers and 100 sister. So, total 101. So, very big family, isn't it? So now, what happened was, there was a war between both of them. Because Duryodhan and the Kauravas, the 100 Kauravas, they are very, very evil. So now, this story, I'm telling the story for one point, that God helps those who help themselves. So what happened on the 13th day of the war? The Kauravas decided that they made a trap. And they wanted to trap Arjuna, but they trapped someone else. Does anyone know who they trapped? Yes?
Abhimanyu.
Yes, Abhimanyu, thank you. Who was Abhimanyu? Yeah?
Arjuna's son,
okay, thank you. So they trapped him and Abhimanyu fought valiantly, but he was all alone and 6 big warriors attacked him. And eventually he was killed. When that happened, sorry?
Yeah,
that is very much against the battle rules. It is. Like say, any of you have watched a cricket match?
My dad does.
It's a good one.
Your dad watches or plays?
Watching it every day, okay. Okay.
So, now in cricket what happens is, say, how many batsmen are there at one time?
Two.
But how many bat at one time?
One.
One bat. And how many bowlers bowl at one time?
One.
So now imagine, if 6 bowlers bowl to a batsman at one time. Then how can the batsman bat? You can defend the ball from one side, but from 5 other sides the ball is coming. The batsman will get out. And that is unfair. So like that, 6 warriors attacking one warrior is completely unfair. So there, when Arjuna came to know that, he became furious. Initially, he was shattered. He started crying in tears. He thought, oh, what is the use of all my skills? I was not there to protect my son. But then when he heard about how treacherously, how cunningly, how, in what a cheating manner, they had killed his son. He said that, I'm going to punish them. And Abhimanyu was trapped because of one warrior. Does anyone know the name of that warrior? Yes? Karna was one of the warriors who killed him. But who is trapped because of one warrior, start from J. Yeah? Yeah, something like Jarasandha, it is Jayadrath. It's Jaja. That's a good song. So Jayadrath. So he had prevented the other warriors from the Pandava side to come and assist Abhimanyu. And that's how Abhimanyu was trapped. So then Arjuna said that because of Jayadrath Abhimanyu was killed, so I will by tomorrow evening kill Jayadrath. So it will be like a race against time. And when the Kauravas came to know about it, they decided that we will use all our forces to stop Arjuna from reaching Jayadrath. And they arranged all the forces like that. So then, that day, that morning, Arjuna started fighting, and one after another, he was fighting so fiercely that nobody could stop in front of him. One after another, different warriors came and everybody was knocked aside. And finally, Duryodhan, he became alarmed and he said to Drona, oh, Dronacharya was the commander. He said, oh, Drona, it seems like Arjuna will destroy our whole army today in one day. Please do something. So Drona said, oh, Duryodhana, the Pandavas have thought their strategy well. All our warriors are caught at strategic points fighting with the various Pandava warriors. And I need to be here to guard Jayadrath. So I cannot spare anyone to fight with Arjuna right now. There's only one warrior who I can spare. I said, who is that? He said, you. Duryodhana says, no, I cannot fight against Arjuna. You know, normally it would be difficult, but in this mood, Arjuna is unstoppable. So Duryodhana, Dronacharya said, don't worry. No, I will empower you. I will give you a special armor. Do you know what is the armor? Yes. What is it? Yes?
Protection.
Protection. But what kind of protection? What do you do with that protection? Yeah, but means it how you wear it.
Yeah.
It's arm. It's a protection that you yeah.
You wear it so like your chest doesn't get like hurt if like they're fighting with swords or something.
Yes, fighting with swords are like we might wear sweater to protect from cold. So armor we use to protect from weapons. And he said this is such a strong armor that nobody will be able to break through it. Even Arjuna will not be able to break through it. And then. Suddenly, as Arjuna was breaking through the Kaurava warriors and coming, he saw right in front of him, Duryodhana. There's Krishna and Duryodhana. Arjuna was surprised. Where was Krishna at this time? In the Kurukshetra war? Yeah?
With Arjuna.
Where?
As his charioteer.
So, Krishna told Arjuna, oh, it seems you can end this war today itself. Duryodhana has come in front of you, you can finish Duryodhana. So Duryodhana said, oh Arjuna, you think you are very powerful? Try all your power. I will crush your pride today. Now Arjuna started shooting arrows. Arjuna's arrows are so powerful that they can break through mountains. But Arjuna's arrows just hit Duryodhana and nothing happened to him. Then Duryodhana started teasing Arjuna. He says, are you out of form today? What happened? So Krishna was asking, Arjuna, this is not the time to lose touch. Then Arjuna started thinking and Arjuna understood, I know what has happened. He is wearing Drona's armor and that's why my arrows are not hurting him. But I know what to do. See what happens, sometimes we face some problem, there seems to be no solution. But if you're intelligent, Krishna will give us the intelligence to find the solution. We try to use our intelligence, then Krishna will give the intelligence. So Arjuna knew that this armor protected the entire body except the tip of the fingers. Tip of the fingers exactly. So Arjuna took aim and one after another he shot arrows right point at the tip of the fingers of Duryodhana. And the arrows went right in the tip of the fingers then. And Duryodhana was thinking nothing will happen to him. Suddenly the arrow pierced. He started screaming and he dropped his bow and arrow. And Krishna and Arjuna started laughing and just went by him. They didn't want to finish him, they wanted to reach Jayadrath. And Duryodhana was so humiliated. He was caught off guard. And finally he got those arrows out and then he applied some herbs and then he charged back. Now by this time, Arjuna had come very close to Jayadrath. Now all the warriors, they would have a flag on top of their chariot. That flag was called like their standard. By that people could identify whose chariot this is. So in the distance Arjuna could see the standard of Jayadrath's chariot. Now I'm there. And Duryodhana started despairing. He says, my whole army couldn't stop Arjuna. What can I do? So at that time he looked and he was despairing, but then he saw that the sun was very close to the horizon, nearly setting. He thought, yes. He said, yesterday we used 6 warriors to bring down Abhimanyu. Today we have Abhimanyu's father, so it's more powerful. So let's use 8 warriors. And he told, he shouted, Drona and Krupa, you come from the front. He says, Karna and Ashwatthama, you come from the left. And then he told 2 other warriors, Burishrava and another warrior to come from the right. And he said, Dushasan and I, we will attack from behind. And suddenly all 8 warriors attacked Arjuna. And Arjuna was just coming close to Ajayadrath, but suddenly like a cloud of arrows, so many arrows that it became like a dark cloud all around him. Now Arjuna was just whirling round and round and round, shooting arrows. Nobody could see when he was putting his hand in the quiver, taking out the arrow, shooting the arrow. And such force he was shooting, that his bow appeared to be like a circle. When he was releasing, again tightening, releasing, tightening, nobody could see that. But although he was shooting with such blinding speed, so many arrows were coming upon him that he just couldn't move forward. He could barely keep the arrows away. And he could also sense that, oh, the sun is sinking in the horizon. And he was so close and he ate so far. He started despairing. And when he started despairing, started being desperate. So at that time, he kept fighting. But then, suddenly, Krishna realized that my friend is in trouble. So Krishna decided to help in his own magical way. Krishna raised his finger. What is Krishna's special weapon? Yes?
Sudarshan Chakra.
Oh, wonderful! Sudarshan Chakra. Excellent. So, he called the Sudarshan Chakra. And then, he just released it. And it went spinning rapidly and it covered the sun. And as it covered the sun, some people say that was the same time an eclipse took place. You know what is an eclipse? What is that?
It's when like the moon covers the sun and then it's like all dark.
Yes. So, some people thought it was an eclipse. Now, it was Krishna's Sudarshan Chakra covering, but eclipse also causes darkness. Sun also causes, the Krishna's disc also caused darkness. But what happened now? The warriors were busy fighting and they thought the sun has set. And they thought the sun has set. So what happened? They started celebrating. And Jayadrath all along had been hiding behind. Hey, Arjun should not reach me. You know, Jayadrath came out. Oh, Arjun, you were going to kill me? Now you will die. Said you said you will enter into the fire. I will light the fire for you. I will light your funeral pyre and you will enter into it. And as he was mocking Arjuna, and Arjuna was disappointed. He just come so close and suddenly thought, I have lost. And then Krishna told Arjuna, without looking back, Krishna was looking at Arjuna, there is still time. Put your most powerful arrow, the Brahmastra, on your bow. Now, when Krishna said, there is still time, Arjuna could have asked, where is time? Sun has set. But there is a time to ask questions and there is a time to not ask any questions. Now, this was what time? Not asking questions. He said, Krishna said, there is time, there must be time. So Arjuna did not ask any questions. He put the bow and then he said, point the arrow towards Rudakshatra's neck. And shoot it in such a way that, towards Jayadrath's neck. Now what had happened was, Jayadrath's father, Rudakshatra, knew that his son would always get into trouble. And one day his son would die because of the foolish trouble that he would get into. So in order to protect his son, he had prayed to the gods and got a special benediction, special blessing. The blessing was that anyone who causes the head of my son to fall on the ground, that person's head will crack into 1,000 pieces. So now, Krishna knew about this boon. So Krishna said, shoot the arrow in such a way that Jayadrath's head will fly from here, far away. And he said, far away from here, there is a mountain Siman Panchak. And there, there's a mount hilly area. And there, Jayadrath's father, Rudakshatra, is performing meditation. So shoot the arrow in such a way that the head will go and fall on his lap. And as Krishna completed his instruction, Arjuna stretched his bow, and at that moment, Krishna removed the Sudarshan Chakra. And Krishna told Arjuna, there is Jayadrath and there is the sun. Shoot! And as everyone was watching, you know, all other warriors, they had put down their bow thinking we have won. And right in front of their eyes, what happened? Arjuna's arrow whizzed through and Jayadrath was watching. And one moment he was laughing and jeering, and the next, he was completely horrified. Before he could do anything, tack, the arrow knocked off his neck and went off, and the neck just flew through the sky. Now Rudakshatra was in meditation, and suddenly he felt someone falling on his body. He looked at, what is it? Hey, it's a head, blood. He pushed it down, and when he pushed it down, he caused that head to fall on the ground. And then what happened? Boom! So, by the blessing that he had only asked, what happened? His own son got, his own head got exploded. So, this is how Krishna is expert. Now, what the demoniac people, what the bad people use to protect themselves, Krishna uses that thing only to destroy them. That is Krishna's expertise. And then as Jayadrath's head fell away, went, disappeared, then the Kauravas started mourning. They collapsed in agony. And Krishna and Arjuna blew their conch shells in celebration. And then they hugged each other. And Arjuna said, Krishna, it is only by your mercy that I was able to win. And Krishna said, oh Arjuna, the expertise in archery that you have shown, nobody could have shown this. This accomplishment is only what you alone could have done. So the story is that in Krishna, Arjuna tried his best. So when Arjuna did everything that he could, then Krishna did what Arjuna couldn't do. Now God helps those who help themselves. We help ourselves means what? We do the best that we can do. If we are studying, we do our best to study. But if we can't understand something, if we can't get something, just do the best that we can, and then Krishna will do what we can't do. So Krishna is our friend in both ways. Whenever we have fear, he will protect us from that fear. And whenever we have something difficult that we have to do, and we are not able to do it, then Krishna will enable us to do it. Such a friend is Krishna. And that friend Krishna, we can always call out very easily by chanting his names and chanting his mantra. Do you know what is the mantra? Yes? Let's say it together. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Any question? Okay. Yes?
If Jayadrath's father is like, he stood up and it's just like the demon who was chasing like Shiva?
It's like that only, yes. Okay. Narkasur. Basmasur, yeah. Good point, thank you. Anything else? Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
We would like to thank Prabhu by saying Hari Bol 3 times, everyone.
Hari Bol, Hari Bol, Hari Bol.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.